You can't miss it. Wherever you are in New York, in fact, around the world. I've been in London, Singapore, Sydney, and certainly in New York in the last week. In-store windows and shop fronts around the world, and it is rainbow flags everywhere. And the reason, of course, it's June is always Pride Month. But June this year, well, the celebrations are much greater because they culminate this weekend with parades planned in major cities around the world. And here in New York, it is World Pride, celebrating or commemorating the 50th anniversary of the Stonewall uprisings in the city. This year, more than ever, major corporations are going out to show they support the LGBTQ plus community. So, what have you got? You've got fast food chain, the Shake Shack, is adorning its drinks with rainbow toppings. Colgate is encouraging customers to smile with pride. And Spotify is releasing special playlists celebrating LGBT artists. Even as I came in today from Newark Airport, the ground on the floor of the carpet had all been painted in rainbow. Not everyone's happy with the corporate cash-ins. Critics say pride has become too commercialised. A rival march is being staged here in New York. Its organisers call the main event a corporate extravaganza. Joining me in the C-suite, Sarah Kate Ellis is the CEO of the LGBT rights GLAAD. Corporate extravaganza. How do you balance the inclusion? You need corporations on board because that brings acceptance within society. How do you balance it?
So I think it's important that you're not just using the community as a marketing tactic. This is about joining, being a good citizen and joining a movement and not just marketing to a community for the month of June. What are you doing the other 11 months of the year? What have you done internally? What are your policies? So you have to look internally first and foremost and see, do you support your own LGBTQ employees, and then go external.
Right, but that, I mean, let's take Google, for example, in San Francisco, which is asking, Googlers in the company are asking for Pride to delist Google over various problems because they say exactly that. The company is not walking the walk.
Well, many companies, we work with many companies, and we evaluate whether or not they're walking the walk and talking the talk. And I think a lot are trying to. It's also really important. P&G is a great example. They explored their history on being LGBTQ inclusive. And what they discovered was they actually weren't. And they put a film together with CNN specials about that and exposing themselves.
If you walk through the mall here at Hudson Yards, where we are, or anywhere in town, the place is awash with rainbows. Does it satisfy you? Does it please you? Or does it somewhat frustrate you that these are just jumping on the bandwagon? Which is it?
I think it pleases me overall because I know that as corporates embrace the LGBTQ community, they're embracing us as employees and they are embracing us outwardly, and that builds acceptance.
That acceptance, there are some serious issues about that. Your latest numbers suggest that amongst youngsters, the level of acceptance is down. Why is this the case?
So we went back after we got, that was shocking news, and we went back into the field and we did focus groups and we found two reasons for that. One is the Trump effect. We're seeing, you know, since he came into power, we've had 114 attacks on the LGBTQ community from his administration, both in rhetoric and actual policy rollbacks. And our youth are impressionable. That's leaving an impression on them. So we're losing them that way. The other way that we're losing them is that more and more LGBTQ youth are saying that they are LGBTQ, right? So it's right. Like 20%. And what we're finding is that that's confusing to the non-LGBTQ youth. They're coming into more contact. So that's education.
So when straights come up against the community, they tend to be questioning and wary rather than accepting. Not the norm, but that's the gist of it.
Well, it's also different identities than we've seen before,
yes.
Right? We've seen lesbian and gay primarily, and now we're seeing more bisexual, pansexual, transgender, gender nonconforming, and those are confusing to people who aren't identifying that way.
Do you think that creates an even greater confusion for corporations as well? Because it's almost to the point where, right, we've got our policies in place for the gays and the lesbians. We know what we're doing with there. That's a safe policy. We can get away with doing this, that, and the other. But now there's an entire raft of things that we have to glom onto that and we don't know what to do.
I don't think so. I think it's treating people as human. It's really kind of essential and normal to do. And it's just seeing people as individuals. And that's what we have, a revolution of individuality.
We need to talk finally about international issues. I mean, Kenya's Supreme Court decided not to decriminalize. Botswana recently did. I travel again more than most. The discrepancy between, say, the US and Europe and other parts of the world, particularly in Africa, is dramatic.
Yes. And I think that is why corporates embracing pride in the LGBTQ community is so important, because it's still criminal in 70 countries, right? And these global companies can have a true impact. And a lot of these companies also, it's the only safe haven for LGBTQ people when they are internet. National.
Listen to this. Taylor Swift. Have a listen.
You are somebody that we don't know, but you're coming at my friends like a missile. Why are you mad when you could be glad? Could be
glad. So glad you're glad.
Yes. That was a surprise.
Was it really?
It was. Yeah, we've worked with her for years, and she's been an avid supporter of the community, but we did not know that we were going to be in her next song.
Well, you can't go wrong with that, can you?
No, and that helps with our youth, right? And building acceptance, because she's a pop culture icon, a living legend, and so many youngsters look up to her. So I was very excited for that.
Happy Pride.
Happy Pride. Thank you.
Thank you very much.